Alright, so let's transfer some stuff. Let's take all. And then store all junk. Okay, that leaves me with actually a fair amount of stuff. Alright, let's exit this. Let's make a Cabot. Yeah. I don't have any razor grain. Nope. No razor grain. Like, we are making do with what we've got, and it's not always the easiest to work with. Okay, containers, supplies. Duffel bag, footlocker. Hollowed out rock. Yeah, I kind of freaking love the idea of a hollowed out rock, like, right here. This doesn't even make sense, but I love it. Anyway, oh. No, I don't want to store it. I want to close out of this. Okay, here we go. Transfer. So let's drop off some junk that we don't give a damn about. Okay, so you're special. That, a lot of these things I can kind of hold on to, but some of these are kind of heavy. One of the Ushankas. Sugar bomb. Like, the thing is, we probably don't need a whole lot of food stuff here, which is kind of handy. We'll put away the bread menace. Refreshing. Like, we've got things to sell. If we can find somebody that's selling, that's buying stuff, oh, we're in a great spot. It's just, until we get there, it's like, hard to work with. Yeah, tons of melons. Oh, but the melons are irradiated. Ah, that's annoying. Put away the beer, put away Grognak the Barbarian. Are the gourds starting to become heavy? Yep, they are. Yeah, so we'll store the gourds and the melons in here. They'll get heavier and heavier as we go on. Oh, we've actually got 15 bobby pins now. Oh, but we still can't open up locks, unfortunately. Mayor Dude's secret stash, yeah. We did already get the chem station. You're correct. However, I pretty much already used the chem station for what I could use it for. Until we get some more, like, bits. Oh, hey, I can make ammo. Well, I think I'm currently stuck using 38s for the most part. Let's make a little bit of ammo. I like that one. Cache of razor grain in the safe. You might be right there. Yeah, so if we can get another settler specifically working on salvage, that'll actually be really good for me. Because that guy, or scavenging, that guy is like pulling in some weird junk. Not wood, which we're going to need more of, but still. Trash can Carl is cool, but Oscar sells more supplies. Funny. I've just been wasting all of my wood. At this point, I've taken to kind of, like, patrolling town, just being like, come on, fight me. Bandits fight- actually, come to think of it, bandits fight me. Let's see if I can, bait some bandits into coming to say hi. We know there's a couple up over here. But seeing them is harder than I thought. Let's see. Yes, I already grabbed the special book. In fact, I just put it away. So we can have it. I really wish I could actually cross the bridge and get this wood over here. Oh, there's a dog. Got it. Just a wild mongrel. I'm wasting a lot of precious ammunition on this one. What if that dog will come back? I don't see it, but the motion blur, or like the distance blurring is making it a little hard. Yeah, it looks like it just booked it and it's gone. Unless it decides to come, like, loop back and around and come through the entrance. think there's no dog. Like the simplicity of the challenge. I love the simplicity of the challenge. Like, this is really cool. It's just also incredibly hard. Yeah. And it can't get to me, so it left. Damn. I was hoping it would go around. Or, I know sometimes they will like, summon, raiders, because they're nearby, but I don't think that's the case here. That sucks. Ooh, more melons!
Seems to be growing well.
So, at this point, we've hit the Stardew Valley, aspect of the game, and, I'm going to have a truly silly amount of melons by the time we're done. I will be a millionaire in the wasteland. Seriously, I will probably make like a huge fortune.
Just wait there.
Oops. I will probably have a sizable fortune.
Take a look.
God damn it, I pressed tab so you'd stop telling the dog what to do. Alright, whatever.
I need to assign someone to this.
Alright, there we go. I really wish I could also farm here. Like, it's a little weird that I can't do jack, apart from tell people what to do. Shit. I keep seeing this railing here and getting excited. There's a little bit of a railing on the other side. This, right here, that I'm aiming at. And I'm like... And then it's not a thing, and I'm like, no, it's not a thing. Alright, whatever. I'm a millionaire. That's great. And let's head over to Red Rocket for a second. Let's see if there is resource respawn in this game or not. I don't think there is. But you never know. Quick save just in case. We got dead mole rats. Alright. So we got a little bit of tires. But I don't think these guys respawned. I think I just missed them on the way in. Yeah, none of the trees regrow, obviously. I assume this sign is too iconic. Yeah, I think we cleaned this place out as effectively as we possibly can. That's a creepy-ass looking piece of grass. At this point, I'm jumping at shadows. Yeah, there's nothing here. Alright, well, that's unfortunate. Wait, there is resource respawning? Because that'd be cool. Oh, let's see. Weapons workbench. What can we do? So I'm mostly using the short pipe rifle. Damage 13. 10 millimeter. See, what can I do with this one? Can you give it a heavy frame? Tempting. Short barrel, nothing. Standard stock. Not gonna mess with that. Standard magazine. Large magazine. Standard sights. Hey, short scope. Let's go with the short scope. That's probably gonna make my job easier. Unfortunately, that, I think, is the extent of what I can make. Which sucks a bit, but it was probably worth it. So loot will respawn. Magazines. Yeah, mostly wondering about like trees and stuff. Oh. Never finished that mole rat. Or looting it anyway. But yeah, so we got a small sniper rifle of a sort. We're still pretty low on resources, unfortunately. And ammo is going to be a problem, but still. Check containers. The problem is I actually already got rid of all the containers in there. So there's nothing. I wonder if I could put down a bunch of containers and loot them. I don't know. I do like how pretty the skyboxes in this game are. Admittedly, it's just like, you know, standard realism, but still. Trees do not return. Hey. Yeah, so we're going to have to start buying wood. Oops, what? No, what? No, stop that. There we go. Did I get another person? Nope. Always gotta check, just in case. So let's, I hear music like that and I get worried. Let's get around. Let's go check out the raider cage. Wonder if I can actually, easy way in. Let's see if the loot has respawned in any of these boxes. Nope, nothing there. Nothing in any of these, so this place is currently still empty. We do have the safe, but I can't get it open. So it doesn't matter. Unfortunately, I think now I'm going to get stuck in this little side area. But that's not the end of the world. Yeah. Because we can move this. I don't know if this is a... It is an invisible... Nope, it's not an invisible wall. You can bypass it. Takes some effort, but it works. You know, let's see if I can jam myself through some of these things. Doesn't look like it. My fence is not fully impregnable, but it would be somebody would be really hard-pressed to get in. I wonder if I can do platforming to get in my house. Yeah, I can. That's cool. Doesn't really solve the dog meat problem. No, maybe I can't platform it my way in here. Oh, that's okay. There's a random ass bathtub up there. Hell if I know it was her. It gets stuck outside base. Troubleshoot defenses. It works, right? Oh yeah, can't even get through there. This is... I'd say it's a problem, but... We're just gonna move it over. Sorry, dog meat. You're on your own. I don't think I can get... Oh, I can't get through that. Okay. Well, we could always just make, like, a doorway. It'll teleport to me or something. I think. If you wait long enough, normal items like plates will respawn. As if they were there from the start. Takes time, a week or two. Interesting. Yeah, the resource generation system in this game is a little arcane for me. And I'm really curious how it all is supposed to work. Okay, nope, that's not a new person. I keep seeing this guy from behind and thinking it's a random woman. But no, it's just a dude with long hair and it's confusing me. Oh, pick it up and cancel the item move. I'll do that the next time. Well, let's sleep for another 24 hours. Who knows, maybe something will pop up. Unfortunately, the hour cycle takes a lot longer than I'd like it to. Which it's unfortunate just because it's like, you know, I guess you could say like I might get attacked during this time, at which point I'd have to wake up and whatnot. Okay, I'll grant that. Yo. We should consider putting on a siren here. You're not overtaxed at all, right? Yeah, you're not. So let's do... Is it... It's under defense, right? No, it's not. It's under resources, miscellaneous. Bell, siren. Requires one, and also copper. Well, that doesn't work. I'm effectively just biding my time until somebody decides that we're easy pickings enough. We could store one of the turrets and hope for this works. Yeah, let's do that. We'll store one of them. That'll reduce my... It'll reduce my defenses, which is a little worrisome. But hopefully, hopefully we don't run into too many issues. Alright, let's see. Does anything respawn yet? No. Yeah, the problem is I picked these houses so clean that there's a very real possibility the resources that would normally spawn in them, won't. Like, we got a couple of things like that lamp that I could never reach. I don't think there's anything left in any of these houses. Hell, I even uprooted the safes. I was... freaking dog meat. I was pretty dang thorough about clearing this place. I guess let's just keep looping. Looping time until stuff happens, because I am here, and I am waiting. And there's not a whole lot of anything that's going to happen until somebody shows up. Oh. Did we get... Oh. We have 15 in... Oh! We had more adhesive at the other one. That's why. Oh! I just realized something. We've got a bunch of resources back at Red Rocket that I scrapped. That's just waiting there. Because you have to connect them via supply chain. I didn't even think about that. The worst itch on my knee. There we go. Yeah, let's go grab that. That might actually be a fair amount of random junk. A little bit of wood. A lot of rubber and some other things. We might be able to turn that into something. God damn it, attack me. Do we really need, like, Preston Garvey around just to piss people off? Like, it does kind of feel like having an angry militiaman, Minuteman, my bad, around made a bit of a difference as far as, like, people having... Ooh, what was this? What are these? Thistle. Neat. Okay, so transfer. Take all. Caring too much, can't run, that's okay. I don't need to run. So investigate Concord? No. Never. We're just going back to Sanctuary. Oh, I can't fast travel while I'm over-encumbered. Well, seeing as I have nothing better to do, let's just slowly walk all the way back. How much weight am I carrying? 377 pounds. That is insane. But, I mean, what are we gonna do? Oh, actually, come to think of it, dog meat.
Hey. Over here.
Dog meat, don't run away from me.
Heads up.
Stop.
Move here.
How much can dog meat carry? I have no idea. I don't know. I'm going to assume dog meat is just about as... I think I just gave him my clothing. I do not know how much dog meat can carry. I'm loading him up with some drugs. But this might actually go faster if we're both evenly encumbered. I really don't know how much he can carry on him. Oh, shit, I have a ton of purified water. Dog can't care anymore. And that did nothing for me. Alright, well that's fine. We almost got to the point where I could get out of here with all this stuff. Either way though, I noticed some like rather handy things go by in the tracker. So, I guess we made it out like bandits. I'm caring too much and can't run. I am very aware of this. I am very aware that I'm slogging down the road, but it's worth it. I should get, like, a giant neon sign on the side of that tower that just says, like, dude. Or there's gotta be, like, a graffiti thing you can do, too, I think, right? I think so. I'll have to take a look at some point. I think even dog meat is over-encumbered. Because dog meat is not moving fast. Alright, whatever. Hopefully he doesn't... I don't even know where he's... Oh, hey. Tire iron. I'm already over-encumbered. Who cares? I just like to imagine all of my, Okay, he is not, in fact, over-encumbered. This is lying to me. I just like to imagine all the people of my town just, like, look up, and here comes Mayor Dude, just, like... bogged down with just junk. just nonsense materials, and it's like, dude, what are you doing? Dude, why? You can make signs and spell out whatever you want.
Yeah.
I'll have to take a look at that once we get back and drop off my resources. Because, like, I'm legitimately curious what kind of weird shenaniganry we can get into along the way here. At least we're almost there. Use commands via conversation. They will ignore their weight limit. Oh, that's cool. I just want it to happen at some point in this run that we wake up and our population's nearly doubled or something silly like that. That'd be so nice. Mayor dude, why are your pockets full of all that crap? I'm just like, thought I heard another noise. I'm keeping my ears, like, I know the phrase is like keep your eyes peeled, but like I'm keeping my eyes tuned for
seems to be growing well. This ain't.
I'm trying to keep my eyes tuned for, we have so many melons. This is silly. My ears tuned for like the sounds of raiders somehow.
Lost track of how many blisters I got.
I need to get more mods that make my settlers more interesting. Player said AV carry weight.
Someone to this.
I don't know, man. I mean, this is like the only time we're ever going to be carrying this much junk with me. There we go. There's the gourds. There's the melons. Because, like, I don't think I'm ever really going to be that over encumbered. We're almost there. Almost there. And then once we get here. Oh, yeah.
Hey. Here.
Okay, dog meat.
Heads up.
Trade. We're going to take all. Yes. Alright, cool. Transfer. Store all junk. Take all. Transfer. Store all junk. I don't know what kind of stuff he's carrying around on him. Okay, we can move again. Oh, this is nice. So let's transfer all these melons. We don't need them. Mole rat meat, don't need it. Molotov cocktails, dog meat. We're getting some really weird stuff. Bunch of pipe pistols, don't need them. Anything with radio. Whoa, Jesus. Oh, right. We've just been picking up purified water, haven't we? Actually, the radroach meat. You know what? Actually, we're gonna take all. We're just gonna transfer it to the workshop. Some of these things will just show up. Come to think of it. Is there. Ah, there's a way of switching between these. That's cool. So we can just switch around as we need. Endangerol syringe, fancy lad cakes, folder, frag grenade, frag mines. Yeah, 52 gourds. Go figure, I'm overburdened. I'm carrying around, like, a silly amount of vegetables and whatnot. Yeah, so let's just store all of our junk in here. We can always sort as needed. Yeah, so it's mostly the stuff that we're picking up. The oh, right, because we have the crazy water filter. Come to think of it. Scoped pipe rifle. Oh, that's what we put away. Let's see. I kind of wish you couldn't put away things that you specifically are like wearing. Oh, there goes my Ushaka hat. All right, that's fine. Cause it's pretty easy to get that one back. All right, cool. So let's re-equip our inventory, apparel, Shanka hat, and scoped pipe rifle. Okay. So there we go. Here, dude, the vegetable wizard. We were getting a lot of nice stuff. No more people. Defense is still bad, but that's fine. Do you guys know what size means when it comes to population? Does that mean we max out at like 6-7 people for this town? Because if that's the case, I'm going to be really upset. But if it maxes out past that, we'll be in a fine position. Okay, Mayor Dude is not wearing his coat. Is Mayor Dude running around in his underwear again? I'll have to double check that. We're in first person, so I actually have no concept of whether or not I'm wearing clothes. I'm wearing a hat, no clothes. Oh man, that's great. Alright, let's see. Oh yeah, I am wearing a hat, no clothes. Whoops. Did not mean for that to happen. Alright, drifter outfit. Oh, Mayor Dude. Everybody just, like, loves him in town, but he's an idiot. We love him, but, like, sometimes we're, like, super worried about him. Oh, hi. Okay, so we actually have enough to make things here. So we want to boost my damage. The hardened receiver looks like a good choice. Didn't really... I mean, 3 extra damage. Let's see if there's anything else I can do. A bit of long barrel. Nope. Standard stock, magazine, muzzle. Bayonet doesn't seem really worthwhile. Quick eject mag might not be a bad move. Ah, long barrel. Gives me some range and accuracy. Well, those are not resources that I'm limited on. Okay, so automatic seems like a bad idea. Hardened it is. And we can also do large magazine. I'm going to keep modifying these for the time being. Oh. Yeah, we don't want reflex. We want to save up for a long scope. But I need a level 1 gun nut before I can get that. Actually, can I level up? If I can level up, that'd be perfect. And the answer does not seem to be nope. I guess we need to keep going for a little while. Let's see. Can I make any drugs? I can make Psycho Jet, but we don't want to do that. Grenade. Yes. This is syringer ammo. That's not really what we want to do, though. Oh, hey. Fiberglass, glass, silver. These are actually worth a fair amount of experience. That's cool. Okay. You could make the syringer ammo anyway. I don't know how much it's worth, though. Because, yeah, we're trying to max out as much experience as we can possibly, like, do. Okay, I have no armor to modify. Oh, that's interesting. God, this is gorgeous. These weather effects are amazing. I love this new mod.
I need to assign someone to this.
It's fun. If you guys have any mods you want me to use, hop on the Discord and send it my way, because this is interesting stuff, and I'd love to use more. What time is it? It is very freaking late. Well, I should probably go to bed. Let's give it another 24 hours. See if anybody else shows up, and then if nobody shows up, we know what to do. I just want somebody to attack me. Mayor Dude has a chemistry set, and we all know why. I just like the imagery of, like, Mayor Dude just doing, like, vinegar and baking soda, and suddenly he just has, like, 70 vials of jet, and everybody's just like, what? No, what? Why? How? Oh, God. And he's just giggling into himself in a corner. This is just the story of Mayor Dude and his insane hijinks. And also lack of mental stability. Hey, I got a fifth person now. Where is? Let's It's probably this person. Assigned to food. Well, let's escape for a second. You're the new guy.
You gotta take things one day at a time.
Just wanted to trade a few things.
Sure.
Alright, so he's got a couple of bottle caps. Some rounds. We're just slowly bleeding all of our new settlers dry. For ammunition. That's okay. Yeah, progress is being made. It's part of the reason why I haven't stopped yet. Because every time I'm like, I start getting disheartened. Every time I start getting disheartened, it's like, oh, you know what? No, I don't need to get disheartened here. Anyway, we're going to command him to work on scavenging. We could do more food, but honestly, we've got 18 food. I don't even know how that specifically works. But if we have him on scavenging, we can do more like gun mods and stuff.
Yeah.
Though I really wish you could scavenge for caps. Like, it floors me a little bit that you can't find money randomly around. It's kind of annoying, really. Oh well. I mean, we're making it work. So here's a question. The size meter is not going up on the right side, so I'm really curious about exactly what that's supposed to mean.
Got work to do. Can't talk now.
Well, let's go back to the horrible haunted mansion. Seeing as nobody wants to live in there, I'm gonna go put more beds in. At the very least, it should kind of increase the attractiveness of the property, even if nobody actually lives here. Okay. And someday we will actually have ourselves a trader post. And then we can actually, like, make progress on this run. Okay, this is getting silly. We might actually be able to level up here. There we go. Yeah, let's just make a silly amount of beds. People like beds, right? I think people like beds. Okay. Let's see. Every settler assigned to food can work 6 plants. I think it's actually 6 food worth of plants, yeah. Because I got like 12. Okay, size is the amount of things in the settlement before you can put anything more. It has nothing to do with the number of settlers. Cool. Alright. I'm just gonna go to freaking town with beds for a little while. We're gonna need them eventually anyway. And we might as well do that before we hit the limit cap. I think when we hit the cap, I'm probably gonna just start, like, salvaging walls and railings off of things. I'm going really silly here. Or, actually, there's a mod that gets rid of the size limitations on these things, too. Should be rather handy. As I go up in floors here, I get less and less passionate about placing them right. Anyway, so we got our 5th settler. We're not gonna put anything more. I mean, so far so good. This is actually feeling really good to me. Yeah, it's 6 units of food, but since most of my food things are only half a unit of food, that's a fair amount, actually.
Seems to be growing well.
Which is why I'm sitting on a truly comical amount of, like, gourds and whatnot. Alright. We still haven't gotten attacked by raiders. Like, we've been doing this specifically for, like, five and a half hours. And nobody's decided to come take pot shots at me. Pisses me off a little bit. I want to fight something. Sorta. Kinda. I'm a little bit worried about when that happens. We'll figure it out. Either way, this was a lot of fun. I like this challenge. It's cool. Oh god, melons. I walk away for a second and suddenly just melons. Melons all over the place. Yeah, seriously. Whenever we finally have some place to sell things, we're just going to be able to just spew fruit at them.
Hope you ain't one of them since. Here to spy on me.
You're living in my town! That would be pretty insidious, honestly.
You know what I call a good day? One that ends without an empty stomach. Yeah?
You know, I like it how these guys are complaining about, like, you know, good day, one without an empty stomach, in kind of a sarcastic way, like he's starving all the time. We're sitting on, like, just a treasure trove of food! You walled the entire town minus the bridge. It makes it all but impossible for you to actually be attacked. Wait, will they, like, not actually attack me as a result of this? Because if that's the case, we're going to have to go... Okay, fine. Let's get rid of some of these walls. Like, I have no idea how the raider mechanic works in this game. Yeah. Yeah, for whatever reason, I can't get down any of these trees here. The other ones, yes. Pathing issues make it all but impossible for anything to get into town. That's a good point. Alright, fine. We'll open it up a little bit. There we go. That way they'll attack us from several familiar angles. Should work better. I'm just surprised that they can't attack me from this direction. Bears and deathclaws will attack if you have some cage, even behind the walls. Oh yeah, that's the one thing that, let's go back and take a look at this. I forgot, cages will, Okay, so we can... Oh, hey, we can actually make, two more mole rat cages. I forgot, if we have, caged things, it makes us more likely to be, like, attacked by things. Still can't do any Brahmin meat. Anything else we can do here? Insect cage. Because we actually have copper now. So this kind of works. Okay, so here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna make an insect cage. We're gonna make a mole rat cage. If we're lucky, we get a bit of both. I'll just put one of my... Oh, god damn it. I'll just put in one of my generators and stuff. Some point I should figure out how to properly lay out one of those, but that'll be okay. Yeah, I forgot. If we have caged animals, it increases the likelihood that something will attack me. Which is actually useful. Okay, so let's see. Oh, I can make another mole rat cage. Do we wanna? Nah, we won't. We'll save those resources for repairs. Because that's probably a little bit more useful. Because honestly, if I can have an infinite loop between these two, that could actually work out great for me. Because I assume I can't make any of these large cages. Yeah. It's fine, miscellaneous. Quitting time siren. I don't know what any of these do. Oh, there's the beta wave emitter. In arena. Uteem. I'll have to look up how they specifically work. Okay, so power generators. I think these only need one each, right? Hope so. Anyway. Let's build a small generator, preferably in this corner. And then we're gonna go back, we're gonna make connectors and switches. So this is a switch. Perfect. This is really confusing that it doesn't quite connect to the fence the way I want it to. Oh, requires copper though. Well, that's unfortunate. Oh, that's fine. We'll put it here instead. Hey, level 9. Okay. So attach wire to that. Attach wire to these. There we go. Okay, cool. So now we actually have some cages. Okay. You can't get out to go get the double meat magazine. Oh, there's something that doubles the amount of meat that I get. Well, that's unfortunate. And we don't want to store this. Nope. So we might actually be able to turn this into a bit of a shooting gallery. Because if we're lucky, what we could do is... get at least one meat from either, and between that and the salvage operations, we might actually be able to have, like, an infinite item farm. One in third chance to be a rad roach. That'll suck a bit. I don't know. I don't really have, like, a proper plan for any of this. I'm just guessing. Okay, did we want to do Gun Nut. Might actually make it so I get extra experience for these two. All the other insects can fly. You're right. We'll quick save before we do any of these. Okay, sharpshooter's grip. I'll take it. Not that great there. Better infinite farm is razor grain, red stag, bear, deathclaw. You're right. Unfortunately, we don't have any razor grain. And until we get it, we're kind of in trouble. Puzzle. So what do we want? Muzzle break. Fury range. Better per shot recoil. Okay, we'll go with the muzzle break. At this point, I'm just spending money because I need to. Okay, is there anything I can make here? Sights and compensator, yeah, so we're gonna need to get other things. Yeah, my kingdom for a razor grain. Pretty much. At some point, it'll show up. But for the time being, probably not. Weapons apparel, aid. Yep, nope. No razor grain. So we'll have to wait. If we're lucky, we'll get somebody coming in with it or something. I don't know. But that's gonna have to wait for later. Someday.